cook. She got the recipe. She got what you need. That girl can cook. That black girl magic. I gotta have it.
Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a copycat version of Applebee's Bourbon Street Chicken and Shrimp. But honey, it's going to be better. Alright, so look, let's go ahead and jump right into it. Alright, so we're going to start off with seasoning our meat. And the first protein that we're going to be using is chicken breast. I have two whole chicken breasts here, and they are boneless. And we're going to coat them with a little bit of olive oil and about a tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. Okay, ooh, I said it right. And a tablespoon of dried thyme to that, because y'all, we got to have us some herbs, okay? If you want to leave that out, you can. But I'm also going to add in a teaspoon of black pepper. And we got to season this up even more with some smoked paprika. All right, smoked. That's the one with the flavor. And a tablespoon of garlic powder, because what's not to have without garlic, right? A tablespoon of Cajun seasoning, some type of Louisiana seasoning or Creole seasoning. Any type will work, okay? And a 1/4 cup of bourbon. Y'all, that's optional, but it is Bourbon Street Chicken, right? I thought so. So look, add in your bourbon, add in all of those seasonings, honey, and combine them. Make sure that chicken breast get coated all the way through, all right? Every part needs to be seasoned. If you want to add a little salt for insurance, honey, go right ahead. But I promise you, this is the perfect mixture for two doggone chicken breasts, all right? If you want to add more chicken, you just double the seasonings, okay? So cover that and set it aside. And now we want to work on our shrimp. I'm using about 1/2 pound of jumbo shrimp. You can use more or less. And we're just going to coat that with a little bit of olive oil and a teaspoon of Old Bay seasoning. You know, because this is seafood. Why not? Louisiana, right? Okay. A teaspoon of garlic powder as well. And 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. Now, if you want to add more, add you some more. All right. 1/2 teaspoon of dried thyme, as well as some more bourbon. If you don't want any bourbon, once again, you can leave it out. All right? So just combine those. When you combine things with your hand, honey, that means you're cooking with love. All right? But if you don't want to get your fingers dirty, you can leave it out. Oh, also, I added a little bit of chili powder. So if you want to add that, you know, go ahead and put some of that in. About 1 teaspoon, all right? So now look, honey, we have our meat seasoned. Let's go ahead and boil these potatoes, because Bourbon Street Chicken and Shrimp has mashed potatoes. So I'm using about 3 cups of chicken broth and 2 cups of water. Okay, it's all about what's in the water, all right? And you want to season that with salt. I know chicken broth can be salty, but still, season it with a little salt, okay? And I like to add in my minced garlic to the water. This gives the potato so much of that garlicky flavor. And honey, when I tell you it's going to be delicious, it's delicious. And I have about 1.5 pounds of red potatoes. I'm going to add those in. And some of them were a little bit bigger than the other ones. So I cut them in half. Some of them I cut into 4ths. I just cut them to where they were all even so that they would cook the same. All right. And you want to cook these. Boil these uncovered until they are completely fork tender. Look at that. Look, they're cooked, honey. You really could just eat them out the pot like that. But, you know, we're making mashed potatoes. So, you know, don't eat them, okay? Don't eat all of them. But look, they're fork tender. And now we can strain these and save some of that liquid. And now we're going to mash them up, okay? So I'm adding in about 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. Y'all, if you want to use milk, you can. But the heavy whipping cream, baby, we're about to whip these potatoes. We're going to whip them real good. But first, we need to mash them up. You saw I added a little bit of butter in there. And I need you to mash them just a little bit, just so you don't tear your blender up. Now, if you want to, then go for it. But you don't say that I'm the one responsible for doing it. Mash them up just a little bit, okay, while they're not whole. And then you're going to pull out your blender, all right? I'm using my immersion blender with the whisk attachment. And I'm going to blend these bad boys until they are smooth and creamy. All right? And listen, you may have to add in more cream as you go. It just depends on your preference. If you like them really creamy, add you some more cream. See that? Just 1/4 cup, okay? But add it as you go. And now we're going to season this with a little bit of black pepper to taste. I'm also going to add in about 1 to 2 teaspoons of salt. And if you feel like it, add you in some Cajun seasoning. I promise you, it won't hurt. Cajun seasoning is the answer to everything, I promise. All right, and blend that up some more. Get those doggone potatoes nice and creamy, and that's it. That's it. All right. So we're back again and we're over medium heat. And now it's time to put this bad boy together. Now I'm adding in just a little bit of butter. And I have some mushrooms and onions that have been sitting in a little bit of bourbon, salt, and pepper. All right, that's it. Y'all see that? You can season them however you like. But like I said, just bourbon, salt, and pepper here. And we're just going to soften these up a little bit by sauteing them, okay? So you want to make sure those mushrooms get nice and brown and crispy and those onions get nice and tender. And then remove them and set them to the side, honey. Just put them in a little bowl and get rid of them, all right? So now it's time to sear our chicken breast. Yes! Okay, add in your seasoned chicken breast. And listen, you want to sear these for about 5 to 7 minutes per side. Now listen, you cannot eat half-cooked chicken. Make sure it's cooked to at least 165 degrees Fahrenheit on the inside, all right? But you want to make sure that it gets nice and pale on top and brown around the edges before you flip. And make sure you press it so that you get the nice sear. If you don't have a grill pan, honey, cast iron or any type of skillet will work, all right? And I'm also going to add on a little bit of Cajun butter on top. Girl, what is Cajun butter? It's just some butter that I whipped together. And guess what? I'm going to put the recipe in the description box, okay? So once your chicken has cooked all the way through for those 5 to 7 minutes per side, take it off and rest it for as long as you allowed it to cook, okay? And now move on to your shrimp. Cook shrimp last because it doesn't take that long and we want it fresh. So I'm adding in my seasoned shrimp. This, about this size, should probably take a minute or so. And once you get those cooked on one side, honey, just flip them to the other side, all right? Don't overcook them. Just cook them just till they get done, all right? You don't want to eat raw shrimp either, all right? So make sure they do get cooked all the way through, all right? And once they're done, honey, you're going to take those off the heat and put them in a bowl and set them aside. And, honey, it's about to be time to assemble, okay? Once again, like I said, if you don't have a grill pan, it's totally fine. Just use a cast iron skillet or any type of skillet that you have, all right? So, honey, look, that's it. Let's go ahead and put this together and plate it up. And there you have it, guys, our Applebee's copycat bourbon chicken and shrimp with our whipped garlic mashed potatoes. Honey, what they gonna have on you when you cook this dish? Nothing. All right, so look, y'all, I want to thank y'all for watching. As always, thank you for supporting my content. And if you try this recipe out, let me know down in the comments how it goes, and I'll see y'all next time in the next video.